Oh, I see. Don't you have to like follow the police there and then you have to like bump donut trucks to get the donuts out of them? I think.
I don't know why I have to follow them. I know exactly where it is.
Well, maybe you don't know.
Because Marge has short-term memory loss.
I like that this one's like at nighttime.
Yeah.
I really like the just the ambience.
Bart's is better in terms of nighttime.
I don't know. This one I really enjoy.
Really?
I like the look of it.
I mean, World 7 takes the cake.
Wait, did you already have to buy the police uniform?
No.
Oh, you just bought it?
I don't think so. Oh. I just bought it so that we don't have to deal with it.
Oh, is this one that you do have to get eventually?
I'm pretty sure.
Oh.
Yeah, I think it was you that was saying last time that we had to buy... Oh, shit.
Yeah, you do have to hit it. Canyon. You're doing real good.
Shit. God.
Stop it. What are you, an angry whopper?
No.
No.
As if I wasn't being like, ah, fuck.
Are you that ninja?
No.
Oh.
I'm a party ninja.
You're a party dude?
I'm a ninja sex party.
Man. Never heard of those before.
No, I'm not finishing it this time.
You're not finishing it?
No.
Yeah, you are.
I made too many dumb mistakes.
Well, just stop being a dumbass. It's like a tiny, slow-moving donut truck. Just bump it from behind, and then wait for its shit to fall out. Oh.
How the fuck did that not count?
I don't know. That's a little weird.
And yet that one counted.
Okay, nice. Okay, cool. This is the same sound effect that's in Amazing Island. When you collect the item.
I don't care, Will.
It's in the basketball minigame.
Wow. Did you ever stop to think that maybe Amazing Island stole that from this game?
Probably.
The Simpsons. Bunch of filthy casuals.
Yeah, because The Simpsons is always the victim. Everyone steals from The Simpsons.
Yeah, man.
Never the other way around.
Nope.
I bet The Simpsons has only ever had original ideas. Because it's the perfect show.
It is. Name one show that's better than
that. I mean, I don't know.
Okay, name 15 shows that are better.
Let me lower the bar a little for you. I don't know. That's all opinion. There are a million shows I like more than The Simpsons.
Exactly. There's none that are better than The Simpsons. Oh. Don't you ever forget.
Okay. Good talk. Good talk, man. Tell me the video game you wish you were playing right now, Jordan.
Suicide Squad, the movie, the game.
No,
Fighter, the movie,
shut
the
up.
Game.
No, the real. I was about to say a real game. I know that's a real game, but serious answer.
Serious answer.
Yes.
Right now.
Yes. What is a game that like you want to have in your hands right now, released or not?
Mario Odyssey, I guess.
Dang.
It's been a while since I played a Mario game.
Yeah, I guess it has been a while for you, hasn't it? I guess the last one would have been 3D World that you played.
Yep.
Extensively.
And Mario 3.
And Mario 3, I suppose.
We did right here on this channel.
Kill me.
Stupid plugs.
Whatever, dude. There's no such thing as stupid plugs.
Yes, there is.
No way.
Well, that's like the same thing as... There's no such thing as a stupid answer or a stupid question. There definitely is.
No, there ain't.
Yes, there is. And you're stupid if you think there isn't.
No. I mean, there is. The idea is that you're encouraging people not to stop doing what they're doing. You say there's no such thing as a stupid question.
Fuck.
Because you don't want people to stop asking questions. Because if you say shit like, yeah, that was a stupid question, then...
Don't ever talk again.
You're gonna, yeah, you're gonna discourage other people from asking.
But that'd be funny.
That's not funny!
Yes, it is.
Yeah, it is, but still...
What's going on here?
Remember, kids, if you're in school... The collector's card is up there. If you're in school, don't be afraid to ask questions. There's no such thing as a stupid question. What are you doing, you friggin' retard? Sorry, that was mean.
That's a stupid statement.
Sorry, I meant renard, which is, I think it means something in French. You have to go onto the other thing.
I don't want to.
The other roof first, shithead. Yeah, over here.
You're a calzone.
You're hotter than the knockers of hell.
Thank you.
I don't know.
Well, who does, Will?
I don't know. Friggin' ask the viewer.
Ask Hugh Hefner. Oh, wait, you can't.
Viewer, on a scale of 1 to
Mr. Plow Jacket.
On a scale of one to Mr. Plow Jacket.
Oh, you took my joke. I was gonna say that.
How bangable is Jordan McQuaid?
You're a prick.
Cause no one will say Mr. Plow Jacket.
I will.
You'll see down in the video like 3 days later, Jordan McQuaid, Mr. Plow Jacket.
I'll say it before the video even comes out.
Oh, well, you just did.
I'm gonna comment it before it even comes out.
Well, you just did.
No, I didn't.
Stop commenting. Stop it.
No.
Don't.
Yes.
If you leave a comment, I'll kill you.
Please. That's sweet bliss to me.
If you leave a comment on this video, I'm gonna block you. Cool. Okay.
Oh, god damn it, no.
Well, look, it's Apu's favorite car, the hover car.
That's not Apu's car. And you're,
that's what I'm saying.
Gosh darn calzone. I'm saying you're... For saying
it. Oh, dude, calzone. Oh, don't even.
Shit.
I would kill for a calzone right now.
I would kill for a baby back...
Ribs?
Nope.
I would kill for a baby's back.
Just for a baby back.
I would kill to break a baby's back right about now.
No.
I could really go for just breaking a baby right now.
I could really go for some crack.
Jordan, I'm gonna tell you the best dead baby jokes that ever were invented, okay?
There's no such thing.
Why was the fence painted red?
Because some guy threw dead babies
out. That was funny. Whoa! That was
did
funny.
Did you just see me go through the crusty sign?
That was funny. Whoa.
I don't think I'm winning this.
Jordan, what's your favorite thing about Halloween?
That people tip over cars because they have an inhuman amount of strength.
What the hell was that?
Do you never hear, like, there were issues here on PEI where apparently, like, a bunch of kids went and, like, actually flipped a car over?
No.
Like, there was a bunch of kids that did it, so it wasn't quite as heavy.
Did they flip it over on themselves?
No.
Oh.
Though they probably should have, because they're little shits.
Let me tell you something, kiddies from PEI watching. If I catch you trying to burn out a house...
I'll burn you.
I'll burn your clothes off.
That's not gonna end too well for you.
Why?
Well, they're gonna have third-degree burns, and then that's, indecent exposure.
And, yeah, well, guess what? Those buildings have all-degree burns. They're all gone. So, guess what? If anything, I'm being very gentle in my revenge by not making you all gone.
No, piss off!
Oh! Oh, boy.
Ah!
Dude, how did you... Why? How did you do that? You friggin' loser? You friggin' dum-dum? You idiot?
Stop.
Oh my god.
Yeah, I ain't winning this now.
The heck, dude? The checkerboard's empty and you just jumped right into someone else's path. They're gonna kill you. Stop this madness at once.
No!
Whoa, wait, are you ahead of him? How are you ahead of him?
Because there is method to this madness, Will.
Don't do it!
I did it.
Oh! Oh!
No! No!
Dude, stop! Why would you do this? There, yes. Don't give in. Back out that way. Then he can't get ahead of you. No, no, no! No.
Oh.
No. You completely screwed yourself out of that one.
Oh my god, that would have been amazing if I won that one.
You had it within reach, and you were just stupoid. And you didn't do it.
It's okay, I got this.
Okay, well,
I'm the
do
best
it this time.
Hit and run player that's ever lived.
Shut up, that's my line.
No, it's not.
Yes, it is.
You've never once said it in this LP.
Okay.
Actually, I feel like you might have.
I've said it. You really don't pay attention to anything I say during these recordings, do you?
I'm in my own little bubble.
That's pretty bad, dude.
No, it's not.
I'm freaking hurt.
It means I get to ignore all negative comments that people say about me.
Nobody says mean things about you.
That's what you think.
That's not what I think. I look at the comments. I'm like you, apparently.
Hey!
What?
You son of a bitch, you took a shortcut!
Yeah, what?
That's not fair.
Yes, oh, of course.
He's not supposed to take shortcuts.
And all the times you took shortcuts, it was completely legit.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Oh, okay. I'm sorry that I don't have a fucking hover
car. No, 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 no. Yeah, make the big jump. Yeah! Big jump. dumbass idiot. You punk-ass piece of shit. You useless garbage under the rug.
That was funny and you know it.
Sweep it under the rug, they say. Maybe I should sweep my co-commentator under the rug.
Please. Oh. That actually sounds fun.
No, it doesn't. It sounds dirty and gross.
Well, that's dead up bugs to your imagination.
Whoa.
You put dead bugs under a rug?
Yeah, dude.
That's gross.
That's where I put them.
Why?
Save them for later.
Why don't you just fucking put them in a dustpan and toss them out like everyone else?
Because I need to keep them in a safe place.
Why?
Because they need a safe space.
They need a brace space.
My life is complicated.
Boyfriend,
don't wanna talk about it. Teenage, we figure it out in the end. Brace face. You remember the episode of Brace Face where her boobs get big?
No.
That was a funny episode. She got like an inflatable bra because she was like, "Ooh, my titties aren't big enough."
Isn't that always an issue?
This is the problem.
Am I
everyone.
Right, ladies?
Am I right, all of you, and some guys too? I suppose. Whoa! Dude, you're on fire right now.
What was shit, I should jump out of the car then.
What was your favorite episode of Brace Face?
I don't remember a whole lot from Brace Face.
Oh, really?
Honest.
Yeah, I don't either. My sister watched a lot, but I didn't. What about... What about Mimi?
I do remember the show What About Mimi. I guess didn't they have an episode where they did the sleepover and they had like a cake in the freezer and like the power went out
and then it all melted.
Yeah, and then it melted, but then they still kept eating. They actually like ate it and
yeah,
stuff.
Yeah,
no, they had pies.
Yeah,
that's what they did. They had frozen pies in there.
Yeah, well, it was
and
like
they all had their own pie.
It was like be resilient, make the best of a bad situation.
I guess.
Kind
or
of
just
thing.
Don't be a shitty kid.
The only thing I never liked about What About Mimi is the character designs, because they were all garbage. Hey, Mimi looked like she like belonged in the 60s. Like, she looked like a hippie. Which was weird. And, like, I get that's the look they were going for, but, like, it wasn't taking place in the 60s. That was the problem. It was modern day.
You remember Pippi Longstocking?
Yeah, everyone remembers Pippi Longstocking. That was, like, a cult phenomenon, dude. Like Anne of Green Gables. It still blows my mind that there's an Anne of Green Gables anime.
Yeah.
That just... It's weird. Because, like, they mention, like, actual places on PEI and stuff. And I'm like, this is an anime from Japan.
Yeah,
and they're,
man.
Like, talking about places I could just, like, get in my car and drive to
awesome.
In an afternoon. Like, it's weird.
I mean, it doesn't look the same.
What do you mean?
The places.
It looks like PEI. The backdrops.
But not right now. Not PEI today.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah. Dude, PEI doesn't look a whole lot different than it did all those years ago.
Yeah.
As long as
as
long as you're staying away from like the highway and stuff, yeah. Like there's still all those like dirt lanes going along like farm hills and stuff and like
especially
middle of
if
nowhere.
You're in Mount Stewart. No one's gonna understand that here.
That was funny.
Thanks, man.
Man. That was great.
Totally tubular.
Stop.
No.
Bart, go to your room. I always hated that Flash.
It
was stupid. It was so dumb.
Not everything Chris does is amazing.
No.
When he does a good job,
he does all right.
He does pretty darn good.
I'd want to see like longer form stuff from him, because like his short stuff's funny, but like there's no substance to it. Like it's just
have to be.
Yeah, there does though.
Does there really?
No, I shouldn't say that. Like, and I shouldn't speak for anyone specifically either. I don't know. I feel like an animator is at home when they're able to actually tell a fleshed out beginning, middle, end story. And you can't do that in 45 seconds when you're making a poop joke or whatever.
I mean, yes, but do you know how long the 45 second video probably took to make?
Well, no, I understand what I'm asking. I understand that. That's not falling on deaf ears,
exactly.
That's a lot of work and effort. It's just at some point down the road, it would be cool to, like, see like to see an animated movie or like an animated TV show and be like guest writer Chris O'Neill and be like whoa like
well, that's almost
oh my
happened
gosh.
A couple times
really
yeah
what
well
you
what
you,
you know the show you know the animated series Hellbenders right
oh yeah
yeah,
that's,
that,
yeah what
that
am I saying
almost happened
right
then there's
yeah,
Leo
yeah.
and Satan almost happened but then he read in the contract where if he signed it, he would have lost all the rights to the characters.
Yeah, I wouldn't have. Well, of course he would have, because they just wouldn't have wanted to do merchandise of everything.
Yep.
That's all that would have been.
Well, you kind of have to find a way to love your job, or else it just kind of becomes a fucking pain.
Dude, you have no idea how many people don't get that privilege at all. Like, that is, like, the 5% of the population get to do that. 19 out of 20 people probably aren't satisfied.
I thought you were going to say, I'm like, no. Well, that doesn't help.
No, 95% of people are not where they want to be.
Bye, Gail. Nice.
The curator's a good... Yeah. I almost said Keurig.
I love the Keurig really is a good vehicle.
I would drive it. I'd have all the coffee in the world.
Redneck Roundup.
Make the joke you make again, Jordan.
What?
Hamburger, hamburger, hamburger.
No. That you know you're a redneck, Wayne. You need a bunch of dry cactuses.
I don't think that's what a redneck is.
You sure?
Well, you know, if you're...
How do you know?
If your neck is red, you might be a redneck.
That was so fucking funny. I almost forgot.
If you're found dead because someone split your throat open, you might be a redneck.
A serial killer.
Whatever, those jokes aren't funny. Rednecks aren't funny anymore, are they? Are they even, a funny thing anymore? I feel like everything that's been said about them...
I feel like people have moved on.
Well, yeah, I feel like everything that could have been funny about rednecks has been said already.
Exploited to death because it's the goddamn internet.
Yeah.
Well, that was a donut.
Not even the internet. I feel like just enough comedians.
In general.
Yeah. No such thing as a dumb question, right, Jordan?
Nope.
Nope as in no there isn't, or nope as in I disagree?
No, there isn't a dumb question.
Oh.
I'm going to be...
You flip-flopping?
This time.
You flip-flopping on that?
No, I'm going to be serious about it.
You're a flip-flopper.
Good.
You're a dirty flopper, you piece of shit.
I need to buy new flip-flops so this works out just
No, you don't. Way. It's fall.
So?
Going into winter. You don't need flip-flops.
Yeah, that means I still... Now if I'm going to dress up like a surfer dude for Halloween.
What if your feet grow razor blades and they cut up the flip-flops?
How the fuck would my feet grow razors?
I don't know. It's not my job to come up with the explanations. I'm not a scientist. Stop zooming in on Marge's boobs, dude. It's making me uncomfortable. Talk to him.
Great conversation.
Good.
Oh, I need her inmate clothes.
Oh, so you have to be a criminal, not a purveyor of the law. Or whatever.
That's fine. I like her inmate officer.
That was
a good thing.
She's stupid.
You shut your mouth.
What are you doing?
Grabbing more coins.
Why are you grabbing more? Oh, because you need that money now. Yeah. You don't have enough money now.
Nope.
God damn it, dude.
The policewoman thing costed a lot.
I think it was 300.
Mm-hmm.
Three
and
big ones.
The curator costed a pretty penny.
God damn it, dude.
What? Well, it betters everyone.
Yeah, but now you have to sit here and just grind coins.
Oh, well. Look, we gotta kill wasps and stuff anyways.
Fine. What are you gonna kill the time doing then? What do you want to have a chat about, Jordan?
That is a good question.
Let's have a chat. Let's have a good old-fashioned podcastium going on here.
Okay.
What do you want to chat about?
Have you seen any recent Oh, you know what?
What?
I saw Blade Runner on Saturday.
Oh yeah?
New Blade Runner.
How was that?
Yeah, I thought it was really good, actually.
That's good. I've heard good things about it. I never saw the original one, so
I didn't either.
I didn't really give a shit.
I saw one of those, What's the Difference videos that Cinefix does.
Uh-huh.
Where it's like, where they compared it, but,
What's the difference?
Blade Runner never actually had a book. It was loosely inspired by a book. What was it? Do Robots Dream of Electric Sheep or something like that?
Okay. Alright. Sure.
But, you know, I really enjoyed the movie. Ryan Gosling did an excellent job, as he always does.
Nice.
It seems like he's doing every type of genre of movie at this point.
Yeah. He's turning into a bit of
Everyman?
Yeah, Tom Cruise, Brad Pitt type. Yeah.
At least he's not doing his own stunts like Tommy.
Tommy.
Like good old Tommy Cruise.
Oh, yeah. At least he's not the Adam Sandler type.
Fuck. I didn't realize Adam Sandler could play guitar.
Yeah, dude. He did like a comedy music career before he did acting.
I honestly didn't know that.
He's a talented guy. He's just jaded as all hell nowadays, and he just doesn't give a shit.
He used to.
Yeah, but then
he used to be good when he put the effort in.
And then he got the McFarlane treatment, where he just became jaded at his job and just wanted money, and now he doesn't care about quality anymore. It's the way a lot of people get. They see the money and they're like, oh, cool. I'm only going to care about this now.
Yeah.
And then they realize that the dark, harsh reality that you can still basically make a living creating shit.
Yeah.
Because not everyone actually cares about quality.
Maybe he should just stop and just produce now.
He won't. Not at all.
And just, you know, support other actors and try and boost them to another level.
Again, I agree with you.
I think he has his own company.
And he has money.
Yeah, he's got like, Happy Gilmore. What the fuck?
Happy Madison.
Yeah, thank you.
You're making me laugh too hard.
No, I'm not. If anything, you're not laughing enough.
You're making me laugh. Don't make me laugh.
Oh, hi, comic book guy. You want to do something? Yeah,
Jordan,
okay.
Don't make me laugh. Oh, what, this guy? Oh, yeah, he wants to do, you're doing the bonus mission now.
Yeah.
For the Kremlin. For the Kremlins on K-Rool's ship. Ooh.
For the Gremlins 2 movie.
Stop. That's a good movie, man.
I got it.
It's the best movie that's ever been made.
Is it, though?
I've never even seen Gremlins.
I've seen bits of the first and second one.
I don't care about either one.
It's fine.
I've heard that Small Soldiers is basically Gremlins, but they're toys. And I didn't like Small Soldiers all that much when I went back to it.
You like it when you were a kid?
I liked it when I was a kid, but I don't like it now.
Yeah, it doesn't hold up.
It's boring and stupid.
Yep.
So
a lot of the stuff doesn't happen in that movie, surprisingly enough.
There's just a bunch of nothing that happens in that movie, and then they have this weirdly drawn out like action sequence at the end that goes on for too long. Like, it's just a horribly paced, shitty movie.
But it could have been so much more.
No, I mean, yes. No, you're right. It could have been.
Any movie can be so much more.
Well, and that's a good concept. Because it's kind of like, it was at the time, it was kind of like that darker, more mature take on like a Toy Story-like movie. So like, there was potential there. There actually was. I shouldn't try and take that away from it. It was just, I don't know, it was just stoopy. Also, viewers, let us know down in the comments if at some point
we should play the Small Soldiers game.
On PlayStation. Do you remember that the promos would always be on that, like, before the VHS would start?
Yeah.
And, like, the Rodeo Burger and shit? Oh, man. I miss the Rodeo Burger so bad.
I don't remember having the Rodeo Burger. I just remember having kids' meals, and I'd ask for no pickles, and Mom would specifically ask for pickles just so she could take them off my burger.
Oh, and then she could have them?
Yep.
What would your mom always get? Would she just get like a Whopper? Whopper combo? Or probably Whopper, I'm guessing.
Yeah.
Because then she could take your pickles.
Yep.
And then she could have like extra pickles.
That's what she always did.
Yeah,
she always took mine.
She could have like extra pickles, so then she wouldn't have to ask for extra pickles. She could just be like, yeah, just get pickles on his.
I don't think it costs anything for extra pickles, though.
Maybe it did at the time. It might have. I don't know.
I'm pretty sure stuff like that doesn't, like, cheese and bacon does, but that's because cheese and bacon cost a lot.
Yeah.
Especially bacon.
They're
Holy
expensive
shit.
For what they are. That's true. Yeah, oh man, the Rodeo Burger, they had the Rodeo Burger, in Canadian Burger King stores up until, like...
Stores?
Or locations, I should say. Because I don't think it ever came back to America formally after the promotion was over.
How about the McRib?
McRib sucks ass. Don't even get me started. Any attempt to synthesize the world's greatest food, you're an asshole. No, but like they had the Rodeo Burger actually in stores on like the value menu until like probably like, why would you do that?
I don't care.
We just lost 100 coins this session.
We lost 50.
Right no, there. I got one too.
Oh yeah, no. I thought you meant just from that.
No. What was I? Oh yeah, sorry. The Rodeo Burger was like a single patty burger with a bun, and it had a friggin' barbecue sauce and an onion ring on it, and that was it. But it was super good. It was super simple. It just tasted like barbecue with onion rings and a burger. Mm. It's just like you were eating a barbecue on a bun. Like, that's what it was. I wonder
why they call it rodeo then.
And the best part was, it was on the value menu for like $1.69. Like, it was nothing. So like, I would always order like a standard like Whopper Junior meal, and then I'd get a rodeo burger extra with it. It cost me like $8.
And then you'd want a straight vom afterwards.
No way.
You ate too much.
No, because I was... No. Screw you, man.
Goddamn crusty stuff.
No, because like, that's why I'd get a Whopper Jr., not a full Whopper. Because if I did have a Whopper combo with that, I'd want a vom. But with a Whopper Jr.
Double Whopper combo.
Yeah, that's what you do, man. Double Whopper combos.
Or Bacon King.
Bacon Kings are good.
Bacon Kings are good, but they're so fucking filling.
They are.
It doesn't help that they have, like, mayo.
Yeah, mayo makes it like extra rich and thick. Yeah.
Well, mayo is like one of the thick condiments. It's probably one of the thickest. Do you ever think, for one second, well, that maybe this is just the rodeo version of the Canyonero?
This is the rodeo burger version of the Canyonero.
This is the rodeo Nero.
It was pretty tasty, huh? You can't handle the rodeo.